Life pro tip. Military dogs are amazing at what they do, but the breeds are high octane and need to be worked. They may not be suitable for all homes as pets without extensive training. Please don't get a dog breed because it is a hero. Get a dog breed because it fits your family's lifestyle.
Four pointers and a husky here. If you don't work working dogs, they're going to make their own work. I think the key tip here is get a dog breed that fits your lifestyle. We fit into my beagle's lifestyle. He tends to sleep a lot. Non-dog owner here. Although my neighbor has a husky, this guy, Zeus, gets carried to the car, driven off for 20 minutes and carried back into the house. I live in Scotland.
Life pro tip. If you really want to connect with someone, take them for a long, scenic walk. Not being face to face takes some of the pressure off, and the scenery puts you in the right mood to open up.
I've heard this is how you get your teenage son to talk. Males don't like talking face to face and are more likely to open up side by side. My son, he's 16, always talks best to me while we are in the car. Until I walk through a spider web and she sees who I truly am. I went jogging with a friend once with the plan to get to know him better as we jogged. He was way fitter than me and ran on ahead. We don't talk anymore. No wonder I am so close with dogs.
Life pro tip. To prep for a hurricane, fill every food storage container you have with water and freeze it now. If you lose power, transfer these giant ice cubes to the fridge. They will keep it sufficiently cool to preserve food for days and provide a drinkable water source as the ice melts.
And then when a storm totally misses, make a lifetime supply of margaritas to celebrate. If only my freezer and fridge had room for boxes of frozen water. I can confirm that this is great advice. Used it when Hurricane Irene hit Virginia in 2005. Asterisk asterisk not glass asterisk asterisk. Ziploc gallon size freezer bags work well. They hold a lot, and when you first put them in, they can flexibly fill in all the gaps.
Life pro tip. Some tips for buying a used car for people that know nothing about cars.
That bit about fuel trims is some of the best used car advice I've ever heard. One thing it adds is to pay attention to the bulb check when you turn the key. Make sure all the warning lights on the dash turn on. This is just to make sure they haven't pulled any bulbs out for items that might not have set in engine code, like ABS or airbags. This is really only for older, non-CAN bus cars, so like 2007-ish and older for most cars. Thank you so much. I'm not even looking for a car but read through this. Happy New Year to you. So I don't just go around and kick all four tires? Will you be my dad?
Life pro tip. You can configure your ad blocker to automatically block all you're using an ad blocker. Annoying messages.
I see you're using an ad blocker for our, you're using an ad blocker, message. Please disable this setting so we can let you know that you're using an ad blocker. Finally, an LPT that I have never heard before, and actually also being the LPT. This is awesome. Your instructions aren't accurate for uBlock Origin on Firefox. At least for me. Here's what I needed to do. 1. Left click on the extension icon and click on the Open the Dashboard button. 2. Same. 3. Click the small plus sign next to Ads and then tick the box that says AdBlock Warning Removal. List. 4. Same. Took me a minute to figure it out. But still, thanks for letting me know that option was available. For ad guard, it's ad blocker. Scroll down to ad filter greater than ad block warning removal list is down under annoyances. I also added the ad guard annoyances filter to stop getting those three-party cookie notices.
Life pro tip. Think twice before buying someone a gift associated with their hobby. Unless you are just as knowledgeable, you will likely buy something they don't want or need.
Please, also don't give the end product as a gift. When I started knitting, I got simple knitted wrist warmers. When I made soap, I got cheap melt and pour soaps. When I kept bees, I got honey. WTF. People. I took up wood carving. Terrible at it, just do it for fun. And last year I was given a 2x4 for my birthday by a relative because I had mentioned I recently took up wood carving. I used it to patch a hole in my fence. As a kid, my favorite gifts were when my parents brought me to the music store and said, pick out a new guitar or pick out a new amp, etc. Where they still thought about what I would want, but let me choose one that I liked. I'm super into fish keeping and someone gave me a fish I wasn't wanting. I didn't have a tank set up for it and it wasn't a community fish that could be compatible with my existing fish. I gave it up to my local fish store.
Life pro tip. Employers put entry level in job titles to trick applicants into accepting less pay. If the entry level job requires you to have significant experience, demand more than starting pay.
I worked at a major global company and they always did this for jobs that required up to 6/7 of a year experience. At my interview, I asked them to clarify why it said entry level. They claimed it was an hour error. Yeah, right. Now hiring entry level developers. Great way to get your foot in the door. Requirements. 5 plus years experience in C, Java, PHP, JavaScript, C++, Python, Shell, Ruby, Objective-C and C#. Bachelor's degree or greater. Low self-worth. I believe this. Businesses make it seem so daunting by putting all kinds of qualifications necessary to the job on their posting and then people are grateful just to get an interview, much less a job. I think it's a negotiation tactic so people accept less pay. Edit. Everyone out there on the job hunt, keep your head up and keep applying. The worst case scenario is that you don't get the job, which is what will happen anyway if you don't apply. Edit 2. I think everyone should read the comment posted on this thread by UGCBealer5. It's especially well thought out and helpful. Yeah, try that working in education. Master's required. 1 to 2 years experience. Entry level. 28k-32k. Edit. Great discussion below, but know that education equals teacher. Many people work in education that are not faculty. I am one of those humans. But teachers, professors get a raw deal frequently, depending on a large number of factors.
Life pro tip: if you need to wait until your boss is in a good mood to ask for something as simple as time off, you're in a toxic work environment and you need to take steps to exit sooner than later.
LMFAO, is this a direct LPT response to the one about asking for things after lunch breaks? ? My boss yells at least 10 swear words every time his phone rings, which is all the time. Then he calmly picks it up and says, hello? Quote. Meanwhile, I'm trying to patiently wait another 7 weeks until my planned last day. Upside down face. After 28 years in the workforce, I don't think I'd recognize a non-toxic work environment if it bit me on the nose. If someone were actually nicer to me than cold shoulder levels of indifference at work, I think I'd strongly suspect they were coming on to me. Every job I've ever had, you meet some of the nicest people when you start. I've learned to ask them what their plans are, 'cause those are always the people who are leaving soon, leaving you with the power-tripping sociopaths and assholes. I don't know where they all go. NASA, maybe? In my experience, people don't quit because of shitty jobs. They quit because of shitty managers.
Life pro tip. Ever need another email address but don't want to register and hold new account? If you added +1, +2, etc, before the end in your email address, websites will register it as a new email, but still send mail to your normal address. Makes organizing accounts or endless free trials much easier.
There's no reason it has to be 1, 2, 3, etc. You can put anything after the plus. Plus Netflix, for example. This is also how you can find out who sold your email to spammers. One caveat is that some sites don't support the plus fully in all of their features. For example, when I signed up for Comcast Internet for the second time, I used my email plus new Comcast. I got the mail to this new email account, but when I tried to unsubscribe, their page was broken. Literally white, because they were not expecting a plus sign and their page threw an error. So yes, it's helpful, but there are flaws. Just want to clarify, it looks like this only works for Gmail. Edit. Thank you all below. It works on Outlook and iCloud as well. What I've gathered from the comments is it can work in several places, but definitely not all of them. This works for Gmail, not all email, and many websites disallow the plus sign. Edit. It works for most email services, not including my old uni email.